we go. Everybody go. The original. Says I'm starting on these bitches invisible. Everything I do so typical. Ain't you want me why these chickens are inquisitive? Started off one
time. Alright, what's good? It's your boy DJ SJ6 from 4, and you're listening to The New York Dose featuring...
This is Mahia covering for Addy this week, and we are with...
Monique
and Kadesha.
And we come from Queens.
The New York Dose is a weekly podcast run by a team of multicultural millennials, bringing you pop culture chit chat, current events, and a dose of New York City.
This show is comprised of three main sections that are broken up into smaller segments. The main sections are The Subway, Empire State of Mind, and Times Square.
If you hear anything you like, use the hashtag TNYD or mention us at The New York Dose so we can converse with you.
The segments in this section correlate with NYC MTA subway lines. Since we have a guest, we're going to make them ride our subway line, transferring from train to train, starting with the G train.
Hey, this is the subway, everybody. We're going to jump right into the guest interview. We come from Queens.
Yes, we do. And now we're here with you guys. Yes.
And we're not in Queens right now.
And New York Dose.
Hello, hello. So, all right, tell us about yourselves. Tell us about who you are. I'm going to just play extremely dumb this whole time. Yes, tell us who you are, what you do. Let's just dive into the tea. Let's start off with...
I'm going to let Monique take it away.
This is fair because I always make her do our intro. So We Come From Queens is a bi-weekly millennial lifestyle podcast that we cover topics from dating. It's probably one that we always end up talking about. We talk about health, mental, physical, emotional wellness. We've talked about financial literacy. We've had, what are the kind of guests? We had connectors on, we've had entrepreneurs on, bloggers, all kind of stuff. So our show really just encompasses anything that a millennial would be going through right now, but just sharing our perspective and then some.
Mm-hmm. Now, how did this come along? Like, who came up with the idea? Who hit up whom? Who decided, hey, let's create a podcast and do it based on XYZ?
So I like to think it was all my idea.
Yes!
I never say that.
One morning, I just woke up and I was like, you know, I think we'll be fabulous if we got a podcast. And Monique was like, that's a great idea, let's go for it.
I remember it just slightly different, actually.
I don't know what you're thinking.
Really?
Okay, so initially, We Come From Queens started as a YouTube channel.
Okay.
I honestly don't remember whose idea it was, but I do know it was a YouTube channel, and we just wanted to do what we're doing now, just like talk about whatever's going on in our personal lives and extend the conversation to others.
You can keep going.
Okay. So we did one episode. We produced one episode, and then
we recorded two.
One
made it to YouTube.
Right, exactly.
Okay. It's still up.
I don't know if it's visible.
Yeah, it's definitely there though, because I was watching it.
I'm gonna check that out.
I actually had planned on posting it soon.
Oh really?
Yes.
rough beginnings.
So yeah, we did that, and then we realized we don't have time for this. Like, we don't have time to meet up on a regular basis to produce these episodes. We were both in kind of like transitional places. Monique was like looking for a job. She was doing a lot of networking. I was working as a teacher, and I was beginning grad school. And you know, for YouTube, you gotta be cute, you gotta make sure you're always on. We didn't have time for that. So we were like, okay, we're gonna have to put a pause button on this and kind of reconvene. And then later on, we decided to do a podcast. I like to believe that it was my idea. She thinks it was hers, so we really don't know who came up with it. But I do remember like listening to my Leaks podcast and feeling like there's something that we could do.
Okay.
So it was a collaborative effort in deciding.
It's just funny how both of us don't really know. Right. So it has to be both of our ideas.
We're the same person, so that works. So in June of 2014, we dropped our first podcast, and it was and June is significant for us because it's our podcast birthday, but it's also the month that we celebrate our birthdays.
Yes.
So yeah, that's just kind of how it was born and started.
I love it.
Here we are.
So you guys said that you are a bi-weekly podcast, right? Now, I guess we already heard the answer, but like, why did you decide to do it bi-weekly? And I know that there's a lot of people out there that always put you ladies to be like, weekly, we want more.
Oh, yeah.
So what What is the decision to kind of be like, no, we're going to keep this bi-weekly and this is going to be our thing?
So, touch like to reiterate what Kalisha just said. When we were starting, she was about to start grad school. I was hustling like crazy. Like, I worked every job that allowed me to contain my dignity. I was doing it, right? So then what happened is I ended up getting a job out of state, and she's with teaching. She was doing a lot of extracurriculars between after school and teaching on other days of the week. And podcasting was just so much easier, again, to do, not in person, but we do bi-weekly because we do everything. We don't have a team. So I'm the one editing the episodes. I'm the one, like, you know, just doing, like, all the stuff. We do a lot of our own research, and it's just, like, for us not to burn out and get overwhelmed doing this, we just have to do it bi-weekly. Yeah, and even just today we were talking about, even though we're a bi-weekly show, we don't miss a release. You're always getting, every 2 weeks, you're getting your episode. And we do bonus episodes, so we call them mini-casts. If there's something going on, we just like need to get something out there. So we like to think that's the extra goodies that you just never know. You might get a mini-cast along with it. But enough people have told us we need to be weekly, and we've thought about it, honestly, but again, we're going to have to build up.
Huh? Honestly, we can't.
Well,
not right now.
Yeah, again, we're in a transitional space again. And I think that's just ultimately life. And I think in order for us to do weekly, we're definitely going to need help, whether it's volunteered help or we pay for it. And we just kind of are not ready to seek that out still. So.
Yeah, in order to keep giving the listeners, I myself am a listener, long-time listener.
Okay. Hey.
And I think, like, to keep it fresh and to keep it, you know, like you said, so you guys don't burn out, people just have to respect that it's bi-weekly.
Yeah.
Because unless they want you guys to, like, because you can hear it when a podcast is, like,
tired.
Yeah, they're tired and they're not enjoying themselves.
Yeah, we don't want to do that.
And you don't want to get to that point.
Right.
Yeah. And I love the little mini, like you said, it's a surprise. Like, I'll be on my phone and then I'm like, oh, snap, they got one today. Like, I enjoy it.
Thank you for listening.
I know, of course.
You also have, on top of that outlet, you also have another outlet that you've incorporated with the podcast, which I love. On your website, I believe, Mo, you have Motivation Mondays, and you have Kadacious Corner. Mm-hmm. So where did the idea for that come up? Because I feel like a lot of, like, because it's blogging, right?
It is.
And I feel like a lot of people have, like, kind of, like, stopped blogging, like, lately. But the fact that you ladies still do it, it's almost, like, something, like, very precious. And it really is a treat to be like, oh, you know, they have this, like, podcast. But they're also kind of doing this, like, journal thing that kind of, like, defers and sometimes matches up. So it's, like, very interesting. So where did the idea for that come from?
So, it initially started with just me doing Kadacious Corner, and that was Monique's idea. She was just like, when we started when we gave our website a makeover.
Yes.
Monique was like, I think there should be like a blogging component to it. She was like, I can't do anything right now. I'm not even going to commit to that, but I think you should. And at that time, I definitely had free time. I had just finished grad school. Mm-hmm. I had taken the summer off of work, so I was just out here like, I have time. And writing is, as you said, is very personal to both of us.
Yeah.
I love writing. I got a master's degree in literacy, so writing is like writing is like one of my loves. It's definitely a passion. And so I coupled that passion with my passion of health and wellness. Mm. And she was just like, yeah, why don't you just write about it and have like your little corner? And I'm like, that's a great idea, Kadacious Corner. So with that, all I'm doing is I'm kind of documenting my fitness, my health wellness journey, but I'm also like giving tips to people. Mm-hmm. And in doing so, like, I'm crafting stories, because writing is an art form. So I believe in not just like dropping information, but dropping it in a way that's artistic and makes you actually want to read it.
Right.
And then eventually I felt like I wanted to join in on this too. So my section of our blog is called Motivation, like a play on my name with the Mo part. And I'm an artist, I'm a creative. And it was important for me to create that section because I know enough of our followers and friends and people that know me are also creative individuals. And there's a lot of highs, but there's almost even way more lows, especially than we even share with people. So for motivation, it's kind of just navigating those spaces and also being so personal, intimate, in a sense of like talking about if I'm having a low moment, like, okay, well, how do I get out of it? Or what things, little things can I do? I'm a big self-care, self-love person. So I incorporate that within it. And sometimes I might just share like a YouTube video or something I watch, maybe not actually curate a post for it. But that is just another thing also to go with us being bi-weekly. It's kind of how we still try to keep active and doing time too. It's like, well, she has her Thursday, I have my Thursday, and then the podcast have two Thursdays.
That's exactly what I was going to say, too. I was going to say, in a sense, you are coming out weekly when you do that, you know? So, yeah.
There's much more content.
Yes.
So right. Just look for it and pay attention.
Absolutely. So, you ladies knew each other before.
Yeah. Podcasting. Yeah, it's very cheesy. Like, totally like the Oprah sign-off sign.
Yeah,
go
Oprah now.
So, I will start this because you know what I'm going to do, right?
I'm
going to
drink
Yeah, that's a good idea. So, Kadesha, we've been friends since we were in sixth grade. What is interesting, the story Kadesha loves to tell, I'll be more specific with it. We were like on the line in the lunchroom in sixth grade, whatever, right?
Lord have mercy.
This is the time, maybe some of you are too young for this, but rolling book bags were a thing, right?
I remember those.
Yes. However, this one particular lunch day, I was completely over it. And Kadesha's in front of me, her book bag's in my way, and like, I just kicked her bag.
No, time out. We actually had an altercation.
I don't
know. Something happened. Some words were said.
I can't remember.
Yeah, I can't remember what the words were, but we were not getting along in that moment.
Right.
And whatever happened, it caused her to just say, you know what, I'm gonna kick this book
bag. It was very, like, I was pissed.
Yeah, she was.
Very, very. Wow. I remember thinking, now I do remember we had an exchange.
Mm-hmm.
So, somewhere between that event and her birthday in June, she invited me to her birthday at, like, what was it called? Empire Skates?
Oh, Empire? My God. Empire. That was just you hanging out. I had a summer party.
Oh, it was a slumber party?
Yeah, my slumber party.
Oh, I thought your birthday was the roller skates.
No, we just hung out there.
Okay, well.
Aww.
She invited me to her birthday party, which was a slumber party, which is crazy right. to think of. That I slept in your house. You invited me to your house after I kicked your bag. Because again, this was my
yeah,
day,
I was
right?
Say, wait, hold on. So you invited the girl over.
Yeah.
You're right.
And another thing is this, okay, another story she likes to tell about that is like, I was a very reserved person. But apparently at this slumber party, I turned up and was doing the Harlem shake, like up and down the Soul Train line. That's me now. Anyways, we just been friends since we were like 12 years old. Like that was just like the beginning.
Well, I guess 11. We say 12, but it was 11.
So did you turn 12?
Yes.
Okay. Mm-hmm. Anyways, like clarifications. But we also had like this off period because she went to high school in the city. I stayed in Queens, so we didn't really see each other.
Mm.
And then we reconnected. Well, her mom's house and where I live is super close to each other. So it adds just extra convenience to the friendship.
Right.
Someone to take the bus back with and the subways and all sorts of stuff.
Oh,
like
I tell people all the time, geography plays a huge role in friendship.
Yeah,
uh-huh.
It really does.
Yeah.
One of my best friends, she was in Brooklyn and we like, you know, fucked around that whole time together and then she moved to the Bronx and I was like, girl.
It was nice
friendship.
I mean, we in a group chat together, so it feels like I see her every day. But yeah, no, that's, all right. So.
I have friends in the Bronx I haven't seen in like 2 years.
It's crazy, it's a whole different world. So you've been around since 2014. Right?
Mm-hmm.
We come from Queens. Where do you see yourselves going in the next 4 years? Like, what is the goal for We Come From Queens?
We have a lot of goals.
Yes.
I think, well, I know that we definitely want to continue to expand. We want to continue to connect with more people.
Mm-hmm.
I always say this whenever people ask us about like what we want to do next. I know we're trying to make some money off of this podcast.
Come on now.
People have often asked us if we reach a place where we are making a certain amount of money, like would we quit our full-time jobs? That's never something that I really want to consider because teaching is
a
passion of mine. Yeah, but it would be nice to be able to do this and do teaching like maybe part-time or something.
Mm-hmm.
But yeah, definitely make more money, continue to connect with more people. Like I value relationships and people, and I value the fact that we've been able to meet so many people. You and I kind of reconnected off of
the podcast,
you know? And
because nobody knows because this is right. Before, but so me and Kadesha actually went to the same high school together.
Yeah,
Tyler and the team. Yes. And it's so funny. And me and Mahia went to the same junior high school.
Really?
So,
yes.
Yeah.
I was in the grade ahead, but
same. I'm a year older.
Yeah. But I was the same age.
Like
we're the same
age. She's scared. Okay.
She
was one of the skippers.
Oh, sorry.
Okay.
Excuse me.
Right.
But I ended up dating underclassmen.
And then
they were my age. And then
mm-hmm.
I met Derek. We didn't date.
Okay. We did. My high was one of my former girlfriends. So oh my god, okay, alright, so what were you saying about?
Right, so, money.
Money, come on.
Continuing to grow relationships and build relationships.
Yes.
like, I want us to do more, like, we talked about community service things, and I think we definitely want to jump in on that and, like, make it a part of, like, how blogging is a part of our thing, making community service a part of it.
Yeah.
That's what I can think of for now.
Yeah, just overall growing, connecting with people, and I feel like you said, just all, like, expanding it. Also, for me, I wouldn't mind doing this as a part-time thing, but again, I am an artist, so I'm in favor of anything that would allow me to still be a creative individual, well, in my sense, or personal to me, and still be able to do that job. Podcasting full-time sounds very, very interesting, too.
It does.
Like, what it would probably require of us
as
well to make sure that we are getting a check.
Mm-hmm.
You might have to be weekly.
Well, that part I don't think would be a problem, but it would be interesting. Yeah, it would be like, I don't know, as long as we can keep our authenticity of who we are, so.
Do you ladies ever think